Good morning, everybody. I am Professor Muhammad Wasim Akram. Welcome to all of you in my video lecture series. I have been teaching this course for the last 12 years. These video lectures will be very useful to the students of civil engineering. So keep watching, like, comment, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you. Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine. In this lecture, we will learn about steps involved in the proportionating of footing. It means how to fix the dimensions of the footing. I mean length and breadth of the footing based on the soil condition. First of all, it is essential to estimate the dead load, live load, and other load, such as wind load and or seismic load that act on the foundation. It is a common practice to assume that the wind load and the seismic load do not act simultaneously. Moreover, since some live loads are temporary and transient, it is necessary to include only that part of the load that may actually induce settlement in the foundation soil. For this reason, in the case of clay soil, where the settlement is time dependent, it is enough if the design is carried out for a reduced value of live load. This being defined as the live load acting for the major part of the life of the structure. Generally, one half of the design live load is taken as permanent. However, for foundations resting on coarse grain soils, the maximum live load that can ever occur is considered irrespective of the duration of such a load. Since settlement can occur in a very short period in such soils, the bending moment at the base of the column or wall, if any, should also be determined. A square footing is preferred when only axial load acts. If the footing is to be designed for bending moment also, in addition to the axial load, a rectangular footing is more suitable. After that, the depth of foundation is fixed suitably by considering the nature of the structure and subsoil condition as revealed by the borehole test data. The proportioning of a footing is a process of optimization, ensuring both safety and economy. For the assumed dimension and depth of footing, the net safe bearing capacity can be calculated on the basis of the soil data obtained from test and using suitable method. The proportionating of a footing is a problem which is interactive in nature. The typical structural engineer's approach of obtaining the plan dimension by dividing the column load or wall load by the so-called bearing capacity cannot be used here. Suitable plan dimensions, namely the width of a square or a strip footing and the width and length if the choice is rectangular footing, have to be assumed to begin with. For this assumed plan area, the net ultimate load intensity Qn is equal to the design load divided by the plan area. Qn should not be allowed to exceed the net allowable bearing pressure. If it does, the design is unsafe. On the other hand, if it is very much less, the design is oversafe and hence uneconomical. That is why the proportionating of a footing is a process of optimization, ensuring both safety and economy. Since net allowable pressure is smaller of net shape bearing capacity for shear and the shape bearing pressure for settlement, both of these considerations will have to be factored in the design. For the assumed dimension and depth of footing, the net shape bearing capacity QNS can be calculated on the basis of the soil data obtained from test and using the method. In granular soils, the standard penetration test or the plate load test gives the data required for this purpose. The N value to be used is the average of the corrected N values from the base of the footing up to a depth equal to the assumed width of the footing. For clay soil, the average undrained shear strength Cu required as input in the bearing capacity equation is obtained from laboratory shear test on a undisturbed sample. Check if Qn is less than equal to Qns. If not, the dimension of the footing need to be revised upward and step 6 is repeated till the check is okay. The total or maximum settlement of the footing is determined using the suitable method. The shape bearing capacity calculated in step 6 is used as the pressure inducing settlement in the settlement computation. The settlement in a clay soil is determined with the shape bearing capacity assumed to act at the base of the footing using consolidation test data. An estimate of the differential settlement between the various footing and the angular distortion between the various parts of the structure is made. The maximum settlement, the differential settlement, and the angular distortion obtained in step 8 are compared with the permissible values given in different tables and or any accepted code of practice. If they are not within the permissible limits, the shape bearing capacity is revised and the settlement computation is repeated to ensure that all the requirements are met. The stability of the footing is checked to ensure safety against sliding and overturning. The factor of safety should not be less than 1.75 against sliding and not less than 2 against overturning when only dead load, live load and earth pressure are considered. It must now be clear why it was said earlier that the proportioning of footing is an interactive procedure. Unless the depth of footing and tentative dimension of the footing are assumed, the average corrected N value cannot be worked out. Also, the soil strata forming the seat of settlement and their thickness are also dependent on the assumed value of depth of foundation and width of foundation. Some investigators believe that while the bearing capacity can be calculated by considering the soil stratum included within the depth of B below the base of the footing, the settlement computation should be done by considering the seat of settlement to be at least 1.5b to 2b below the footing base, where capital B is the width of footing. So we can follow these steps to proportionate the foundation.